We're back here at the virtual House of Swing, the 25th anniversary of our international Essentially Ellington. Coming up next, Rio Americano High School from Sacramento, California, directed by a native New Yorker, Josh Murray.
Hello, everyone. I'm Josh Murray, band director at Rio Americano High School in Sacramento, California. The Essentially Ellington Festival is far and away the finest program with which I have ever been associated. Our sincere thanks go out to all the festival staff. I would also like to thank my teaching partner, Mitch Evett, as well as the Rio Band parents and community, and especially our dedicated and spirited students for their hard work. Now, current events highlight the need for educators to use jazz as a way to engage in frank, difficult, and often uncomfortable conversations with students about race and the brutal history that is at the heart of the creation of the music we all hold dear. These conversations give students a deeper connection to the music they are playing and help create informed citizens who are equipped to stand up for social justice. It's our moral obligation. Now, you'll hear our version of Dizzy Gillespie's A Night in Tunisia, featuring Michael Gilbert on bass, Grayson Cliff on trombone, Sam Flores on guitar, Ellie Wu on piano, Jackson Irvine on vibraphone, and Grady Flam on trumpet. Thank you. Thank you.
was Rio Americano High School from Sacramento, California, directed by Josh Murray, playing Dizzy Gillespie's Night in Tunisia. We're here with Josh Murray and Alexa Tarantino. Alexa, you have some thoughts on that particular performance?
Thanks, Todd. Great job, everybody. Nice to see you all, sending good vibes. I loved that performance. Awesome energy all around. The shaping and the attention to dynamics and articulation was great. I would have loved to hear that first trombone melodic solo come out of the gate even more with some fire behind it. And I think, you know, in general, just continuing using, you know, as much clarity as possible in our improvised solos, really digging into the time. But in general, love the releases, love that bass intro, and keep it going. Keep that spirit and energy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Josh, any feedback?
No, I mean, I was really pleased with it. I know that that our kids were working really, really, really hard, and we decided to sort of throw that bass intro on the front, and Michael Gilbert really did a heck of a job playing that. And then, you know, we put a lot of things in the able hands of our soloists and Grady Flam over there on trumpet.
So talk a little bit about your programming choices. You'd had a very wide variety of styles. How did you make that choice?
Well, it's always, you know, you got to look at what's going to work best for your band. So you got to look at the makeup of the band each year and figure out what charts are going to fit best, so that you make the choices that work best for the kids, that they're going to enjoy playing and really, you know, invest them their own personalities in, and that's going to showcase the band to the best, because you want to get into the Essentially Ellington Festival.
And who do you have with us? You have a couple students with us.
Yeah, we've got our lead trumpet player, who was featured on that tune, Grady Flam, who's a senior or just graduated. And then we have a junior alto sax and clarinet player. We have Catherine Treadwell.
Great. Grady and Catherine, glad you could join us. Catherine, how are you feeling about the performance we just heard?
I'm really proud of it, honestly. We put a lot of effort into it and a lot of hard work, a lot of sectionals. Yeah.
Awesome. And Grady, how about you?
I feel great about the performance. I tried to do my best to honor the great Dizzy Gillespie, but as we all know, he and perhaps Louis Armstrong are the two most inimitable trumpet players. I mean, in my opinion, just between the virtuosity and everything else. So, had to really dig deep to try to do it justice. But I can. I just hope that I did a good job with that. So, but I feel good about the performance. I thought it's a good representation. Good captured this band very well.
Alexa, do you have any comments on Grady's solo on Night in Egypt?
Yeah, it was great. Great energy, great range, and definitely in the spirit of Dizzy. And of course, I agree with you. You know, two very, both of those trumpet players, big shoes to fill, but very impressed and just wishing you the best of luck. Keep it up and, stick with your own original voice too. I love that you had your own ideas in there as well. So
Thank you. One of the things that was mentioned in the judges' meeting was that you're one of the first trumpet players wasn't played today live, but you recorded Portrait of Louis Armstrong. Yeah. And you didn't quote Winton.
Yeah, I knew that was definitely a little bit of that song is a rite of passage for a lot of trumpet players, but it also has a certain kind of minefield you have to avoid. People, you know, it's been so played and you have to, you know, carve out your own space and add something original to it. So I tried to listen to previous versions of course, Witten. I tried to, you know, evoke him, but not imitate him. But and just previous versions of, musicians from Rio, people who have played it before, and just so many great versions that I tried to encapsulate in that one. So thank you.
And Grady, what are you doing next year?
I'll be studying jazz studies at the University of Southern California, the Thornton School of Music.
And Catherine, we assume you're going to go back to Rio Americano for a senior year. Are you to declare yourself a professional and sign with the band?
Yeah. Gonna go to Rio.
Oh, maybe we'll see you next year. Again, congratulations, Josh, Grady, and Catherine. Congratulations to the whole band and the community. Just a wonderful performance. We hope you stay safe out there, and we'll see you again. Hopefully, we'll see you next year.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right. Coming up next, we have Garfield High School, longtime finalist band from Seattle, Washington.